everyone. Welcome to Daily Prelims Current Affairs by Neo IAS. Today on the 31st March, the topics we will be discussing are Lonar Crater Lake, Pradhan Mantri Rozgar Protsahan Yojana, Smart India Hackathon 2018 and TESS. First topic is Lonar Crater Lake. The Mumbai High Court has directed the civil authorities to evict the slum dwellers from the Lonar Lake embankment. So this Lonar Crater Lake is suspected to have developed due to the impact of a large meteorite on Deccan basaltic rocks some 50,000 years ago. It's the world's only high velocity meteor crater in hard basalt, and it doesn't erode or changes its qualities easily. The lake is remarkable such that its water is both saline and alkaline. This Lonar Lake supports microorganisms rarely found elsewhere on the earth, like biological nitrogen fixation was discovered in this lake due to the microbial activities in the highly alkaline character of the water. Then the lake is also surrounded with fragments of minerals like maskelyneite. It is a kind of naturally occurring glass that is only formed by extremely high velocity impacts. As you can see in the map, this Lonar Crater Lake is in Maharashtra. Other craters in India are Thala Crater and Ramgarh Crater. This Thala Crater is formed by an asteroid impact itself. It is situated in Madhya Pradesh, and it is the second such crater found in India after Lonar Lake. This Thala Crater is considered as the largest in India, as well as the largest crater between the Mediterranean and Southeast Asia. The second is Ramgarh Crater. It is a potential meteor crater in Kota Plateau of Vindhya Range in Rajasthan. The Geological Survey of India is examining the prospects of declaring this crater as a National Geological Monument. Second topic is Pradhan Mantri Rozgar Protsahan Yojana. The Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has given its approval for enhancing the scope of this Pradhan Mantri Rozgar Protsahan Yojana. Under the scheme, the government pays the mandatory 8.33% contribution of employers to the Employees Pension Scheme for new employees. To be eligible, the employees should have joined on or after 1st April 2016, should have a new universal account number, and the salary should not be above ₹15,000 per month. And for the establishment, it must be registered with Employees Provident Fund Organization, as well as it should have a labor identification number which is allotted under Shram Suvidha portal. So the changes the committee has brought in is that the government will now contribute to this employer's full admissible contribution for the first 3 years from the date of registration of the new employee for all the sectors. Also, it will include existing beneficiaries for their remaining period of 3 years. The primary objective of the Pradhan Mantri Rozgar Protsahan Yojana is to incentivize employers for generation of new employment. Also, it will increase the access of employees to social security benefits in the organized sector. Smart India Hackathon 2018. All India Council for Technical Education under the aegis of Ministry of Human Resource Development is organizing the Smart India Hackathon 2018. The Smart India Hackathon 2018 would be the second massive scale hackathon initiative in India following Smart India Hackathon 2017. There will be two sub-editions, software as well as hardware. It is a unique initiative to identify new and disruptive digital technology innovations for solving the challenges faced by a country. Through this initiative, government departments is trying to engage thousands of technical students and challenge them to build digital solutions to improve the efficiency, then plug revenue leakages and bring down corruption. Some of the problems are solution to predict drought in a protected area, which is from the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. Also, the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare is looking for a solution in the telemedicine system that can work on low bandwidth. The last topic is TESS, Transiting Exoplanet Survey Satellite. The NASA is launching TESS, which aims to find alien worlds with capacity to harbor life. This test aims to discover a number of planets whose atmospheric compositions which hold potential clues to the presence of life. It will be launched on Falcon 9. Falcon 9 is a rocket developed by the private company SpaceX. This test will orbit the Earth every 13.7 days. And it will be using 4 cameras to search 85% of the entire sky for these exoplanets. The spacecraft will be looking for a phenomenon known as a transit, which means when a planet passes in front of its star, it causes a periodic and regular dip in the star's brightness. The test will concentrate on stars less than 300 light years away and 30 to 100 times brighter than the Kepler telescope. This test will survey an area 400 times larger than what Kepler observed. The properties of such identified planets will be probed by NASA's upcoming James Webb Space Telescope and other missions. For more news and detailed explanations, please refer to our new IAS current affairs material. That's all for the day. Thank you for watching.